Good morning. I am really delighted to address all of you. I am going to talk about spoken tutorials, FOSS, and also the low cost laptop. We are happy to be doing this as a part of Digital India celebrations. I want to thank the colleges for having joined this lecture in a short notice. How do I go?
Just click on this arrow.
Next. Okay. Okay. I will talk about the spoken tutorials and FOSS laptops mainly. The motivation for this work is as follows. 50% of Indians are below 25 years, two-thirds below 35 years. The pain points are education quality, finding good teachers, providing jobs, and of course, we are a very large country. IT training can improve employment scenario and also the quality of life. Let me first talk about spoken tutorials. When we started this project, we came up with some problem statements. So we wanted to train students without teachers, mainly because of shortage of teachers. Many students don't have access to teachers. So how do we do this without teachers? We said, make the content suitable for self-learning. That is a solution. Then we said, the content should be suitable for self-learning. How do we do this? So we wrote scripts for every tutorial and made a novice check. A beginner has to certify that it is something that he or she can follow. In other words, a novice has to clear the script before it is recorded. Learning pedagogy should be effective. So we came up with the side-by-side method. You can see video on the left-hand side and the software on the right-hand side. So you see them side by side and practice, you listen to the video and then practice it on the software on the other side. And this is possible only with open source software. We want every student to be able to download and practice the software simultaneously, which is possible only with open source software, which is available to everybody, and it also makes everybody equal. Okay, it democratizes learning. And of course, in this method, every command has to be reproduced. As a result, we say that our method promotes active learning. Lack of computers is another problem. Many of our students don't have, many of our children don't have access to computers. So we came up with low-cost computers. I have a computer here. I'm going to talk about this a little later, but this is something that, I have, you can see Wikipedia, Telugu Wikipedia offline. I'll come back to this a little later. What happened? Did they get all this or?
No, sir.
Wait, also, I also need internet. Okay. What is that, my video? Not able to hear. Okay. Not able to start the current session. Can we have the fan on till the time? You keep the fan speed at a very low speed and leave it on. उसको दे दो इधर. You get me the internet also.
Yeah, sure.
No, no, where is it? I want to check it. Is it this? So what do I have to do? I should click the browser.
That window.
Which window? This window?
First one.
This one? Okay, then? So can they see this now?
No, no. If you want to show this one, you have to share the desktop sharing. Then they can see this one.
No, but you tell me how to do, what I should do. Press the button, whatever. This is AVU.
Share desktop.
Okay. This is the one?
No, AVU window.
Which is AV window?
This one.
This
last
one?
Last one.
That's what I pressed.
This one, yeah.
This one. Which one? This one?
Left side.
Yeah.
Okay. Then what do I do?
Share desktop.
Then it's a share button.
Keep the mouse over there. Left side.
Start desktop sharing.
If you press this one, they can see them. Scan an area.
No. Start this. Should I close this? Sorry, close this.
Again, press the share desktop.
Okay.
Screen area.
Okay. Now, can they see both?
Yeah.
Now they will be able to see both. But how do I go to?
Interact with someone.
Okay, how do I ask them?
Minimize AV window.
This one also I'll minimize. Let's see what
they can tell them. They are
click on user and then interact with someone. User. Left side, yeah.
They are able to see the slides and hear us.
Yeah,
they are able to see. Now, what about this? I want them to check whether they can hear.
Yeah. Just select the user, we will confirm it.
Can they see this? Yeah.
We will interact with someone.
Hey, don't worry about it. Just leave it there. Just want to check whether they can hear, see this. When what comes?
This bracket. Yeah.
Where is the bracket? That means they can see.
They can see.
They can see.
Yeah.
So they are able to see this also. Should I just go?
Yeah.
Good morning. I hope you can see me now. Can somebody tell me whether it, you can see it? Okay. I believe we are okay. Let's get started. So I'm going to talk about Spoken Tutorials, FOSSI, and also the low cost laptops. The motivation for this work, both of those, are employment for our children. Many of our children are at a very young age, but the problem is that they have difficulty finding good teachers, getting jobs, and of course we are a large continent, and IT training can improve employment scenario and quality of life. I get the mail that audio is not clear. Okay, so can somebody, I believe that it is okay for most people, for those of you who cannot hear, maybe you should check the, some other people are saying that they are getting good audio, so those who are not getting should check their side, okay. The main objective of our projects is to improve the employment potential, and so that they can, our children can get good jobs. So let me get on with Spoken Tutorials. When we started this project, we had these objectives. We wanted a method to train students without teachers, not because we wanted to make the teachers jobless, but because many of our students don't have access to good teachers, especially in tier 3, tier 4 colleges. So here is the problem statement and here is the solution. What is the solution? Make the content suitable for self-learning. So how do we do this? So then again we post that as a problem statement. The content should be suitable for self-learning. What is the solution to this? We write script for every tutorial, do a novice check. A beginner has to certify that the script is simple enough, the video will be simple enough to be recorded. Okay, do a novice check of the script first. And of course, we do a lot of pilot projects, pilot workshops and so on. In order for self-learning to be effective, we wanted an effective pedagogy. So how do we do that? We came up with a side-by-side learning method. In this method, we don't maximize either the spoken tutorial or the software. So the spoken tutorial is indicated by video here. So that is taken to half the side of the screen. In other half, we have the software itself. For example, here we are teaching Scilab. This is Scilab spoken tutorial. This is actual Scilab software itself. And what do we do? Of course, we can do this only with open source software, because if I ask the student to download a commercial software, only rich students can do this. Not every student can do this. So this method of using open source software makes everybody equal. It gives equal opportunity to everybody. It democratizes learning. And in this method, every command shown in the video has to be reproduced. As a result, the student just does not just listen, but actually practices. And so this promotes active learning. The other problem our children have is the lack of computers. So we came up with low cost computers, less than $100. For example, you see here, this is our low cost computer, and you know, on the screen you can see Hindi Wikipedia available for offline use. I'm going to talk about this little later in this talk. Okay, we go to the next one. Lack of computer is another problem. How do we address this? So we conduct organized workshops through colleges, and the colleges can make available their computers and the students can participate, can use them. So we came up with this methodology called self workshop. What does SELF stand for? Spoken Tutorial Based Education and Learning through free FOSS study workshops. Of course, now we have gone a step further. we are now incorporating the training in your academic calendar itself. So what are these workshops? So these workshops can be done through your curriculum or independently as well. These are called self workshops. These are 2-hour workshops. Typically our labs are of 2-hour duration, can be organized by a volunteer. An expert is not required. The same person who conducts a workshop can repeat several other workshops. A person who conducts a C workshop can organize a Blender workshop, Java workshop, Perl workshop, and so on. The method is the same. Okay, as I said earlier, individual computers are not required, and more importantly, all these things are available free of cost to academic institutions, and there is no financial implication. A principal can easily sign without worrying about the consequences. It's absolutely free. The principal does not have to pay a single paisa. Then lack of awareness of our free tutorials, and we signed MOU with several universities and colleges, about 2000 colleges for example. Lack of English fluency is another issue. Many of our children, although pretty smart, are not necessarily fluent in English. So how do we address this? We said that we will dub our tutorials in all 22 languages of India. Okay, I have these. So what we will do is to see this, let's go to the website. So let me take for example LibreOffice Writer, very popular software equivalent to MS Word. Let me take Telugu. Okay, now you can see that 6 tutorials are there. Let me make this slightly bigger. Let me see if I can make it zoom, make it bigger. So let's take one of these. Okay, let me play this. I hope you will be able to hear this. In case you cannot hear this, you can always do this yourself in your browser. Go to Spoken Tutorial. I have selected Telugu and then LibreOffice Writer. And then depending on the
LibreOffice typing the text మరియు basic formatting గురించి తెలియబరిచే spoken tutorial కు స్వాగతం. ఈ tutorial లో మనం నేర్చుకునేది రైటర్ లో టెక్స్ట్ ను సమరేఖలోనికి తెచ్చుట, బుల్లెట్స్ మరియు నంబరింగ్, రైటర్ లో కట్ కాపీ లోని ఎడమ మార్జిన్ వైపు. ఒకవేళ అలైన్ రైట్ పై క్లిక్ చేస్తే
ఓకే, ఐ పాస్డ్ ఇట్, యు విల్ బి ఏబుల్ టు సీ దిస్ అండ్ యు కెన్ సీ దట్ this is everything is video is in English, only the spoken part is in the mother tongue of the child. What this does is it retains the employment opportunities, because the child learns to use a normal computer, use a English keyboard, and that child can also aspire for a job in TCS or Infosys or any other IT company. But even if she is weak in English, this video explains to her. And if you scroll down here, all the required things are there. And if you go down, all the required files for this are also available, code files. For example, here it opens a file called resume.odt and it's available here. Okay, so let me come back here. You go to the next slide. This is, we are of course dubbing this in all 22 languages, and Telugu also has a large number of tutorials. By the way, we are looking for people to dub more tutorials in Telugu. We are doing slightly not so well in Telugu. We should have dubbed many more tutorials into Telugu. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, the employment in IT industry needs English. So we said dub only the audio. Dubbing requires only 5% effort, and okay, let me see what happened. So I showed dubbing, okay, I showed dubbing only in Telugu. Let me see if I can, we can also dub this in other languages. Let me just go back and let me take for example we take Hindi. So let me take so this is Hindi. We play this.
LibreOffice Writer के spoken tutorial में आपका स्वागत है. इस tutorial में हम writer के बारे में सीखेंगे.
Okay. But what is more important is it is also possible in several other languages. For example, if you see, we have 115 tutorials in Sanskrit, which I would say is a very you know, it's not a language spoken by many people. But we decided to do this in all 22 languages in our 8th schedule of the constitution. This goes to show that we can actually provide this kind of training even to linguistic minorities whom we have in India. Okay, let me just lack of internet is another problem. So what we did was we came up with an offline download application, and the reach increased by 15 times. Let me see if I can show you how to do that, because this is important. Many of you would want to use this. In this, in software training tab, as you see, I am in Spoken Tutorial website. In the software training tab, if you click this, there is something called create your own disk image. You click that, here you can select whatever you want. For example, suppose you want C and C++, and then you say that I want only basic level. And then I want let's say English and Hindi, and then add the selected files. It comes and says it is 208 MB. Let me take for example LibreOffice Writer. For example, you may want to give this training to the secretaries in your office so that you can switch over to LibreOffice completely to your entire university. So you say it is added. So together it is about 248 MB. So if you are ready, you just say create zip file. What it will do is it will start downloading this, right? It will give you the zip file, and then of course it will take some time because this is 250 MB. But then once you download it on one computer, you can copy the zip file onto every machine. For example, it comes and asks, what do I do? I will not open it. If you can save it, you can open it, whatever, but here I will cancel it. This zip file can be copied into every machine, and then the students can start. There will be a file called index.html. If they open it, it will give the look and feel of our website. Which website? This website. It will look like this. So whatever you downloaded will be available. So it is not required for every computer to have internet connection. You need only one computer with internet connection through which you will download the zip file. If you have the internet connection, you can do this yourself. If you don't have it, if you don't have even one connection also, we can do. At that time, you have to ask us, and then we can create that zip file and send it to you. Or you can go to a friend's college and then download it there. Okay. So let me advance. A lot of people have seen our website. It's doubling every year. And then there are very interesting web statistics also, but we don't have to worry about this now. We did a Java training in Hyderabad. I have a student who is doing PhD in computer in education technology. He offered the same Java training through traditional classroom, and then 180 students participated in this, and then the self workshops. 220 students participated. Of course, we did this through 6 workshops. Each workshop trained about 35 students. Together, we trained 400 students. There were 250 males and 150 females. All this happened in Hyderabad. We wanted to compare the performance of the students who did self workshop versus those who went through actual classroom. So, what is the result? We said whoever wants to do self workshop can go, and whoever wants to go to the classroom can go. So these students chose these two methods voluntarily. Nobody was forced to do that. We found the overall performance in post test. At the end of the semester, we did a test, and we found that overall performance in post test was about equal, and what is more interesting, the self confidence was high amongst workshop learners. Those who went through workshop training, they felt very confident. In fact, they said they could do many other things through by themselves, and in fact it turned out the workshop women learners actually did better than both classroom males as well as classroom females. So this is a very interesting study. So this is something we did in Hyderabad by our PhD student in education technology. Okay, let me go to the next one. We also got some feedback from several people who listened to our spoken tutorial methodology, who underwent spoken tutorial methodology. So we have feedback from 25,000 participants. Quality of our instructional material, good or very good. Basically, if it is, you have high towers here, that means it is good. Quality of infrastructure, it is good or very good. Quality of college organizer, good or very good. Remember, the college organizer does not have to teach anything. They just have to make sure that everything is readily available. They have to enforce discipline. Quality of IIT Bombay mentor, we also do not have to do much because everything is in the tutorial. Once again, good or very good. We just have to connect and say, hi, how are you? We are doing fine. Get started. You can do it yourself. That is it. Okay. Overall quality, good or very good. Usefulness of the topic studied, quite a few students also say somewhat. What this shows is that students, many students do a workshop, it is available free. So they just do it. Maybe it will be useful to a job, but until they get a job, they are not sure. So that is why quite a few people said somewhat useful, but very few people say it is useful, very little and so on. Okay. Will they recommend spoken tutorial to others? Likely, quite likely, definitely. By the way, I missed one thing. Let me just go back. Quality of infrastructure, that I forgot to talk about. Quite a few students say it is only fair, right? That is because all these workshops happen in your colleges, and there are colleges that do not have good infrastructure and they say it is only fair. Of course, we invite good colleges to throw open their computer labs and invite students from nearby colleges, those who don't have the opportunity to have good infrastructure, to invite them and offer them also this kind of training if you have surplus time in your colleges. So let me go forward. Usefulness, as I said, it's only somewhat for some people. Will they recommend spoken tutorial to others? Likely, quite likely, definitely. Very few people say no. Out of 25,000, less than 1,000 people said they will not recommend. Summary, spoken tutorial is a 10-minute long screencast created for self-learning, dubbed into all 22 languages. It teaches IT through open source software, massive IT training through universities and colleges. Okay. We have a large number of topics on which we can offer self-workshops. Our training team is with you, people who organize these today's talk, for example, will be delighted to organize all of these. In fact, this is only a partial. We have many more. They will be delighted to offer this to you, all free of cost. We trained 6 lakh people in the first 3 years, but in 2014 alone, we trained 3.5 lakh. In 2015, we expect to train about 7 lakh students. Now, I talked about spoken tutorial for IT training, but this is this can be generalized for all kinds of IT skills, applicable to all demonstration based topics. You know, for example, carpentry, plumbing, circuit layout, etc. How to stand in the queue, how to climb the stairs, how to open a door, how to enter when a door is opened, how to use a washroom in an airplane. So how do you teach all these sensitive topics? You can do this through spoken tutorial. Okay. In fact, I met a teacher, I met a faculty member in Indian Institute of Primary Healthcare in Hyderabad, and she said that children in boys especially in villages, climb up the stairs, climb up the trees, climb down, they jump off, they fall off, they fracture their hands. Sometimes it could take 2-3 hours for them to get the first aid. They may have to go to the nearest town, wait for the doctor, and if they are not well informed, they could keep their hand hanging loose and permanently damaging their hand. She said all that they have to do is just open the shirt button and just keep it here, just keep it on this and then hold it there until they get the first aid from the doctor. She said if only we can do this, we can just get rid of this problem. She said create a spoken tutorial, dub this into every language and then make it available to every primary healthcare center. Okay. So of course, what jobs and so on, bridging digital divide, health related skills, that is what I talked about. It is interesting that every woman spends quite a bit of time at home during childbirth, and they have a lot of time. They cannot do physical work, they can actually listen to all of this. In other words, it is possible to create spoken tutorials on all these kind of topics and make them available, and I believe that if we do this, we can actually become a developed country. In that sense, IT training is only tip of the iceberg. We can make this available for entire IT training. Okay, I want to spend a few minutes on our project FOSSE. FOSSE stands for Free and Open Source Software for Education. I believe what I am going to talk now is also going to be very useful for all the colleges who are listening to it. In particular, I want to talk about Scilab. I believe that Scilab is a great software. You can use it to replace MATLAB with it. We can replace Scilab by promoting Scilab, replace MATLAB by promoting Scilab. And on all these topics, we are developing, we are making Scilab toolboxes comparable to MATLAB. More importantly, we have a project that is available only in Scilab but not in MATLAB. This is called Textbook Companion. Okay. What is a textbook companion? We wanted to create text, we wanted to create documentation so that we know how to learn Scilab. Okay. The biggest problem in open source software is documentation. So we wanted to make use of our large number of students to create documents, but students are bad in documentation. So the question was, how do we use the students we have? So we said, let us solve the inverse problem. What is this? To write code to solve problems from standard textbooks. You take a standard textbook, write code to solved problems, solved examples. Okay. Verify the results with the book and collect all this, collect all the Scilab code for every solved examples, and that is released as a textbook companion, and textbook becomes the documentation. You have the code here and you have the textbook here as the documentation. I am going to demonstrate this. We also pay a honorarium to these students. Okay, let me just show you. Okay, in fact, I think it is in the next slide. We have a very large number of textbook companions. We have 500 Scilab textbook companions. We have about 300 in progress. So let me just give a demo of Scilab textbook companion on cloud. So let me go here. So what I will do is, now let me just go to cloud.scilab.in. So this is cloud. This is hosted on Garuda website, Garuda Cloud in Bangalore. So whatever operation I do will go to Garuda, will go to Garuda cloud in Bangalore, and it will do this. So how do I do that? Let me take an example from, let us say, control theory and control systems. This is my happens to be my subject. Let me select a book. Let me take this Automatic Control Systems by BC Co. So let me take frequency domain analysis, let me take Bode plot. So the moment I do that, the example coded by the student appears here. By the way, we have this for all the vectored examples. This is example 9.15 in chapter 9 of this book, okay. Now we have, so this kind of code is available for every example in this book, and we have this for more than 500 books. This only Scilab has. So now if I execute this, what happens is this information goes to Bangalore, as I mentioned earlier. Of course, you need internet connection for this. So what do? If you don't have internet connection, I'll show you how to do it here. When we come to scilab.in, this is our Scilab website, and this is something that we are maintaining. You can see that there is something called Textbook Companion Project. So click that, and you have something called Textbook Companion Completed Books. So let me click this Completed Books. So you can see that number of completed books is 506, and you have it on various things, fluid mechanics, control theory, and so on. So let me go to control theory that I told you. Let me click this, then it will take you to whoever it is. It says that it is done by a student called Arpita Hadar, B.Tech pursuing electronics engineering, NIT Karnataka, NITK Suratkal, okay, and college teacher, and then reviewer, we have all of that. In the meantime, let me come here, see that it has already been computed. It went to Garuda Cloud in Bangalore. The results are here. I can also download this if I want. This is the Bode plot. Let me close this. Here is the thing. Now, if I don't like this, I want to change this. Let me change this. For example, change it to 5000, double the gain, execute it. Now, this whole thing will repeat. Now this will become 5000, gain margin and phase margin will change, you get new Bode plot and so on. In other words, whatever you want to do with that example can be done with this. We have this for 500 textbooks in, for you know, that you would use in your university, for example. So let me go back. So I gave this demo. By the way, we have excellent set of spoken tutorials on Scilab. So our team can offer you Scilab spoken tutorials, and then we have Textbook Companion. You can, through that you can learn Scilab, you can also use them in your curriculum, and some of your students may want to do Textbook Companion, and your teacher may want to review them, and we give honorarium to both of them. So we want you to become a part of this activity. And of course, Scilab is not the only thing. We promote Python, OpenFOAM, eSIM, DWSIM, many things, okay. Visit our, talk to team members who organized today's workshop for more details. So I want to spend a few minutes on our low-cost laptop. I showed you a little earlier. So what is this project about? The Akash project was successful. We identified the shortcomings. We solved them in the laptop. Okay. Our cost, of course, was 4990 plus tax, customs, etc. If you include all of this to IIT Bombay, the total cost came to 5800. By the way, we bought this in November 2014. So that is almost, I would say, about 8-9 months ago, number one. Number two, we also got this machine to do research study, to find out whether this is an effective system, okay. So for people who don't have either of the two, that is they want to buy it today, that means about 8 months later when dollar has appreciated quite a bit more, number one. Number two, for actual use, not for research, the price will be little more. We believe that it can be made available for 6800. In case any of your students will be interested, we can connect them with the vendor. But mind you, this is available only for bulk purchasers. For example, if your college wants to buy it and make it available, then it is possible. Because the problem is, supposing a student buys a computer through mail order and something stops working, who will attend to that? It will become very expensive to send it by post, get it back, and it should not break. So all kinds of things are there. So we expect people to, a college to buy this and then set up a service center and then the vendor will give all the required services and you can use it in your curriculum. In fact, I want to talk about this a little more. Now we are conducting a pilot study with 1000 netbooks. What is our role in this laptop? We are coming up with a voice distribution. Okay, we are figuring out how to install voice and so on. Well, actually, you know, I made a mistake. What is our contribution? We figured out how to install wires. In fact, it came as a closed source. What we did was our people even had to solder some wires to the motherboard, bring them out, get the log file, figure out how this machine was working. Okay, we ported many useful open source software. For this, we have more than 100 software systems available on this, many things that you use in your curriculum. Okay, of course, we provide training also how to use it. Spoken tutorials are available on this machine. Okay, let me just show you. So, I showed you that Wikipedia, I already showed you. So, let me now show this spoken tutorial, because I told you that. So I told you that spoken tutorials can be made available. So here is a spoken tutorial. So let me choose once again LibreOffice Writer in Telugu. By the way, this is not at all, it is now offline. So let me write typing text, let me just see if I can show something else, inserting pictures and objects. Okay, let me play this, hopefully you will be able to hear this. Okay, let me pause it. Right. So, I showed you the Wikipedia, offline Wikipedia, it has 70,000-80,000 articles in Telugu alone, and it is also possible to make available the spoken tutorials for offline use. So, even training is available. So, it has a great build, number one, it has very good set of software packages, and it can also be used for training. All these three things are available. Okay. Now I want to share our CS101 experience with you, CS101 at IIT Bombay. At IIT Bombay, we have a course called CS101. It is a compulsory course for all first year students. Out of 450 students who did this course last semester, we found that 50 students did not have their own laptops. Okay? 50 students did not have laptops, 400 students had laptop. Now, Wouldn't that put these 50 students at a disadvantage in a programming course where the students have to, you know, spend time? Supposing a student does not have a computer, of course, at IIT Bombay, we give computers in the lab. Okay? It is possible for a student to come to the lab and do this. All students stay in the hostels. It is possible for them. But suppose this student gets an idea at 10 o'clock in the night, okay? 5-minute idea. This student has to walk all the way to the lab. If he has key permission, get the keys, open the lab, get into the lab, turn the lights on, computer on and so on, try it out and close everything, reverse all the things, come back to his room. To test the 5-minute idea, it will take 1 hour. I can tell you, those ideas will never get tested. Okay? If this is the situation at IIT, you can imagine how it is in other places in your colleges. Many of your students will be day scholars. Many of them will not have computers at home. How will they try? No wonder many of these children learn the program by heart. That is the only way they can pass the test, pass the exam. They do not have access to computer. We believe that it is possible through our laptop. By the way, we gave our laptops to the 50 students as requested by the faculty member. At the end of the semester, the professor was very happy and he said that the students really benefited. So I would like to recommend this to you. In case any of your colleges wants to have this, you can even have a lending library. You can even have a lending library. You can lend them to your day scholars. In fact, I know one college that is interested in acquiring these computers because their placement session is clashing with their labs, computer labs, because the placement companies, companies that come for placement want computers, the students are tied up. So if they give it to placement, then the students for the labs cannot use computers. So they are thinking about getting these machines and also using them for lending in the evening for day scholars. Okay. So I believe that through this method, it is possible to make available computers to all your students at a very low cost. We are talking about 6,800, and you can also provide after sale support by setting up a small service center in your own college. All this can be made possible. We can put you in touch with the vendor. So with that, I would like to end my talk. I want to thank you for listening to me, and the main emphasis is of our work is open source software, hands-on training, and then active learning, collaborative approach, and this methodology can be extended to several other methods of training as well. We can make your children employable, and if your children get better jobs, it's good for all of you and it is good for the country. So with that, I would like to conclude my talk. We are grateful to our funding agency. It's funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. Thank you, and Jai Hind. Okay, so I can tell you what is the configuration of the laptop. Sorry, I forgot to include it. What I can do is, I see that some of you wanted a copy of these slides. I can make this available, but in that slide itself, I will include the details. But let me tell you right now what the features are. It has 1 GB RAM, 8 GB NAND flash. It's an ARM chip and ARM V7 processor. One nice thing about this is it has excellent connectivity. You can see it here. You can see that it has two USB ports. It has a mini HDMI port. It even has a LAN connection here. You can see that LAN connection. Of course, here is a battery charger. It is lightweight. You can carry it in one hand. It's only 700 grams. And what else? It has excellent battery time. If you don't use internet, we have seen even something like 6-7 hours. Even with internet, we have seen something like 3-4 hours. We are also working on creating a solar charger so that if you that is available at an additional cost of 1000 rupees, and if you buy it at 1000 rupees, where you know, electricity problem is there, it can give 2 full charges in a day. Okay. So if there are any specific questions about this device, I'll be happy to answer them. This runs a version of Ubuntu, and of course we have really customized it to run efficiently. It requires only 100 MB at runtime. By the way, the RAM on this is 1 GB, right? If there are any specific questions, I'll be able to answer them. Let's see if Thank you. happy to see all of you.
Yes.
Please go ahead. The voice is not clear. I cannot understand. Slightly better. Sorry. It is still not clear. Sorry about it. Can you, if you don't mind, can you just type it on the chat window so that I can at least see, because I'm unable to hear you. Do they have something? So what's it? So apparently you have selected camera mic. You should select the proper device, then it will come properly. That's the reason why your audio is not coming properly. Okay, thank you. Okay, welcome participants from Andhra University. So some people wanted to check from Andhra University. Are they coming back? So I have selected Andhra University. Great to see so many people there. Your mic is not on. Can you please check that? Cannot hear you. I still can't hear you. Okay, let me see if what should I do? Select them again.
Sir, VC is going to join us in within 5 or 10 minutes.
Okay.
And meanwhile, what we will do, other colleges and universities are there online. Mm. We will interact with them. For that, you just have to click on user, which is at the extreme left. Yes. So right now, Andhra University we can see, but we cannot hear them.
Yeah. Okay. So I'll see whether there is anybody else. JNTU, Kakinada. This is the same thing?
Yes, yes.
Chakravarti. This is somebody else. Should I select?
Kakinada is also, so we have to interact with them also.
So let me select.
Start.
I have selected Chakravarti.
JNTU Kakinada. Hmm? Professor Kannan, it's thank start.
Yeah, hi, I can hear you.
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you. This is Dr. Krishna Prasad from JNTU Kakinada.
Good afternoon.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. Thanks for giving awareness. Coming to, is there any registration is required to access spoken tutorials and textbook companions? Or those are open source?
They are all open source.
All are open source?
All are open source, yeah.
Okay. And second question, mm-hmm. coming to low-cost laptop. I will take this as an opportunity to appreciate your efforts.
Thank you.
Is it possible to enhance the RAM? You mentioned only 1 GB RAM is available there.
Yeah, it is possible. Only thing is, we have gone for a device which we thought was good enough, right?
Okay.
So one can always add more at a higher price. And naturally, if there is enough order, large order, the manufacturer may be willing to modify also. But then I believe that this is good enough for most purposes. Because we wanted to keep the price low, that was the main objective.
Mm. Thank you, Professor.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So let me.
So this is Professor JVR Murthy from Computer Science Department.
Good afternoon.
From JNTU Kakinada. Sir, we will be happy. We want to include these Skylab things into our curriculum. Mm-hmm. So we appreciate your concern about it, sir, because we have a lot of MATLAB tools using for image processing work and various other things we have. The circuit analysis concepts and all. So we will shortly plan to replace that with the Skylab.
We'll be delighted to help you.
Really, we appreciate bringing the kind of awareness amongst these.
Okay. So we will go to, let me see. Okay. Okay, we have some more people here. Shall we go here? JNTU. Okay, this is. BW said. So you have a question there? Okay, so they are not ready yet. So we will go to the next one. Okay, BJ.
Hello.
Yeah, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Yeah, this. Yeah, this is Amrish from School of PG Studies. Okay, so we have MBA course also in our campus. Have you developed any tutorials for the management students so that it will be helpful to the management students also?
our in IT. Literacy is, although IT literacy is one of the main objectives, we still have things like, we have a team in FOSSI that works on operations research. There is something called OR toolbox that we are working on. So let me just see if I can show you. I have come to our website. Let me go to FOSSI.in. I have to share the thing. Okay, let me first share that first. Where is it? Down. Here, this one. Start desktop sharing. Okay, let me just share that. Screen area. Okay. Okay, now I got this. So let me go here. So this is FOSSI.in. So I'm going to our website FOSSI.in. This is the one that promotes higher level help. So you can see that here eSIM, CFD, optimization simulation, area of OR tools. So let me click this. So FOSS tools for operations research. So this is something that we have just started, and I can put you in touch with our team members, with these team members. All that you have to do is, you can take our spoken tutorial coordinators of your college, of your state, as the main contact person for IIT Bombay. So whatever information you want, you can get in touch with them. We are all a family. They will contact the right people and provide the required information. Okay, any other question do you have? So let me stop the desktop sharing. Should I do that? There.
War tools and you can chapter, sir. So still it is in process and you chapter.
Okay, so let me go to Sri Vasavi Engineering College.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, thank you very much for this wonderful session, sir, first of all.
Can you keep the mic a little away from your mouth, because there is an echo. Yeah, keep it at a distance.
Okay, sir.
Let's see.
Is it all right, sir, now?
Now it is better, yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. And because we have this AVU, can we use it for posting our live sessions, which can be used in our institution itself?
Yeah, you can do that. You can do
we
that.
We can.
You can do that, yeah.
Okay, sir. That means we need to take a permission from that Amrita University, Amrita Virtual Interactive people?
It's actually, they have already given permission. You can download it in all your colleges and start using. You can do this. For example,
and,
computer science.
We are very much.
Supposing you have it in three sections. The same lecturer can address all three sections.
Okay. And another thing is, because you have given that live sessions of this IT skills like Python and other courses, they'll be regularly being updated. Our students are supposed to interact, or any messages can we receive from the side whoever.
So we have something called forums. We have forums.
Okay.
So a student can actually go and say that in this family, that let's say C++, in this tutorial,
yes, sir,
let's say for loops, at this minute, at this time, I tried this, it is not working. Can you please help? That kind of forum we have created especially for spoken tutorials. So I would like your students to try that. And there are people in our team that will help. But instead of asking, we may not be able to answer general questions like, how do I get a job, you know, things like that. But if you say that, as I mentioned, in this first family of your tutorials, and in this specific tutorial, right, function, you have a spoken tutorial called functions. In that spoken tutorial, at 3 minutes, 25 seconds, I have this question. They can ask this specific question, we'll be able to answer them. Okay, so this is the extra help that we give to over and above the spoken tutorials.
Okay.
Yeah.
And to know about what are the sessions that are being, because the schedule of the sessions will be initially, to be posted there?
No.
By,
no, that will be made available locally. So I think you please get in touch with our spoken tutorial team who organized this workshop for you, who organized this session for you. Get in touch with them. Tell them that you want to organize some workshop, or tell them, ask them, what is the procedure to organize these workshops at your college? They'll be more than happy.
Okay.
In fact, I will, let me just show you.
Thank you very much.
Let me just show you how to get in touch with them. Let me go to screen area. Let me show you how you can get in touch with them. Let me come here. In our spoken tutorial website, where is it? Okay, let me start again. SpokenTutorial.org. If you see here, in the very first tab is software training. Very first thing is about the training. If you click that, and it tells all about our spoken tutorial, the methodology, the topics, and how does one organize, for example, instruction for this, instruction for that, and so on and so forth. Finally, at the bottom, it gives you the name of the person. For example, for Andhra, it is Pallavi Nile, who takes care of it. For Telangana, it is Muhammad Qasim Khan. His email address is given here. His phone number is given here. Feel free to call them. Feel free to call Pallavi or Muhammad Qasim. Or if you have a friend in some other state, for example in Puducherry, feel free to call Preeti Naidu. And if you have some general questions, high level questions, your vice chancellor wants to meet, your college principal wants to talk, you may even want to talk to our national coordinator, Chama Iyer. They are all funded by our project Spoken Tutorial. As I mentioned earlier, these are all funded by NME ICT, MHRD, Government of India. So let me go back. So please feel free to get in touch with them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your wonderful session. Nice to speak to you, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Hello.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. I still cannot hear you well.
Yes.
You want to keep the mic at a distance and speak? Let's see whether that helps.
Yeah. Is it audible, sir?
Slightly better. So, one other thing you can do is just turn off this mic. Just turn off the mic and then speak. Just turn it off.
Yes, sir?
I can hear you. Just turn off that mic and see if you can. Yeah, see?
Hello, sir?
Yeah, it's better now.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. This is from the interview of Mr. Kosev.
Yeah, good afternoon.
And we have taken a number of photos here as part of our aspect of the interview that we have to. And our students have got benefited out of the session that they have taken. And some of our students have been trained from latex. And now they are making use of this latex for writing their documentation and the projects. And it's very helpful for them to write the documentation, not only for their projects, but even they have written some of the papers that they have published in this latex. And they are very happy with this, sir. Thank you very much for giving us the opportunity to work with you. Getting the interpretation done by my staff members. Your voice is not coming clearly, but happy to have you as a resource center. We are really delighted that JNTU could join us, and we look forward to all colleges benefiting by this project, which is funded by taxpayers' money. I want all of you to keep that in mind. It's funded by taxpayers' money, and why should only one college get it? Why should only one student get to use it? Why not all students, all colleges benefit by this? Thank you. Yeah, we can speak over the phone also. Yeah. I can hear you very well. Thank you. You are also unable to hear my voice. Okay, sorry about it.
it's a delight. Yeah. I'm really delighted. Let me repeat what I said earlier. This this project itself is funded by MHRD, and I would say it is from the taxpayers' money. We are really delighted that it is going to the students, and then we always ask why not everybody is using it. I'm really delighted that yes. That's right. Everybody in the university should use it. Yes.
We'll take necessary steps to create the arrangement. See that every student gets involved.
Yeah, we'll be happy to assist you. I'll be, you know, our team is always helpful. But if there is any problem, yes, you can get back to me and my. Yeah. You may also consider. I also talked about this low-cost laptop. You probably didn't see it. This is the, you can see the, yeah. This is available for about a little less than 7,000 rupees. And it, yeah. And it is, in fact, we found that even for IIT Bombay students, the first programming course, we found it to be good enough. Found it to be good enough, and it is also possible to have some of these things available on this. Let me just play this. Let me see. If I can play this Telugu. Okay. So it is possible for us to deliver, preload our spoken tutorials. Good spoken tutorials in Telugu, for example, Telugu, Hindi, or whatever language that is required. Plus, also even Wikipedia for offline use. All of them can be used offline. Internet connection is not required. So, it can also be used for training. So, it will empower a large number of students, because if they don't have computers, many students learn to just learn by heart. They don't learn programming and they don't get jobs. So it will be a great thing that we can do if we can empower them. It may even be possible for some colleges to buy sufficient number, use them in their labs, and also use them as a lending a library in the evenings for day scholars. The students can borrow, come back in the evening, come back in the morning, return it. They can do, you can do all kinds of things. Yeah. Yes, thank you. I see. So what did you study here? I see. Okay. Really delighted. Oh, Abhijit Mukherjee. Because Tarun Khan still stays outside. He comes to IIT for walk every day. Yeah. Yes. I will tell Professor Tarun Khan. Really happy to have you. Yeah. Thank you. Let me see if you can go to Andhra University. So they don't have, they have to raise their, they have to ask questions. I can select them. This is the one? Is it Layla Institute or what? Let me just see. Can you ask them to raise their hand? Andhra University, can you please raise your hand? Use the hand raise option so that I can select you. Because right now we have many centers, I don't know how to select you. Okay, in the meantime, let me select DNR College of Technology. Yeah. Yeah, please go ahead.
Hello, sir.
Hello, yeah, please go ahead.
Is it audible, sir?
Yeah, it's okay. Go ahead.
Ask sir, sir, is it audible?
Yeah, it is audible.
Good morning, sir. We are very happy to listening to your session. So my question is regarding the free cost laptop, sir. So if you want to purchase all the bulk amount of laptops for the students, who is the contact person?
What I will do is when I upload the slides, I will upload that information also. The name of this person is Mayank Jha. There is a company called myvidyut.com. Myvidyut.com. And let me see if I can. What I will do is I will write his phone number on the chat window. I think that will be better. Mayank Jha, the phone number is 8826354. So I have written it in the chat session, chat window, Mr. Mayank Jha, 8826254294. So you can get in touch with him. And then, as I mentioned earlier, we'll be happy to work with institutions. Okay?
Thank you.
Thank you. So let me go to, there is a Loyola College of Engineering. Let me select them. Yeah, from your side video is not coming in case you want to talk.
Sir, next we can call to Pulla Reddy College. G. Pulla Reddy College. They are there.
Pulla Reddy?
Yes. Yeah, second option.
Sir, that
came. Just before that, I think. Yeah, go ahead. Your mic is not on. Can't hear you. Perhaps your mic is not on. Just check that. So I will come back here, just in the meantime just check your mic because I cannot hear you, nobody can hear. So let me go to Pulla Reddy College of Engineering. Jeep.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hi. So we can hear you.
Hello.
Yes.
I can hear you well. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hello.
Can you not hear us?
Yeah, sir, it's audible, sir.
Yeah, please go ahead. I can hear you also.
Sir, this year the site process is changed and I think we are not having workshops anymore. Only training programs are there.
We graduated from training programs to embedding into the curriculum. Embedding into the curriculum, into the syllabus.
Okay, yes.
Mapping and so on reduces the work for everybody. But in case there is somebody for various reasons cannot do this mapping, you still want to do the workshop, we can still do it, although it is little more work.
Okay.
We can still do that if you want, but we recommend the mapping and including in the academic calendar.
We are in the process of actually creating the CSV files and we need to create the master batch student list number first.
Yeah, the reason is...
We are in that process.
Yeah, you understand why we are asking for that.
Once it is over, we'll upload. Once it is over, we'll map this course mapping. Semester training planner we'll prepare then, sir.
Yes.
And accordingly, we'll follow for this semester.
Yeah, we'll be glad to have your inputs. We'll be glad to have the Pulla Reddy College of Engineering to come on board and do all our courses.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, Professor.
Last year, because of tridecennial celebrations, we could not be so active in the second semester.
So, fine, we will be happy to have you. Thank you. They should raise their hand. If somebody wants, they should raise their hand. How do we know how to search? So those who want to ask questions should raise their hand so that I can easily. Anyway, there is a Venkatesa Perumal College of Engineering. Is the same thing?
When this can be initiated?
Tirupati is not there.
Dr. V.R.